Hi, I am Julian Bro. I am an economist and policy specialist. Today, I will be teaching you about the market for loanable funds, where savers can lend and borrowers can borrow funds. We will be talking about savings and investments, and then about the role of the financial system. We will finish by a quick overview of how markets for loanable funds work. First, let's talk about saving and investment. The same as in real life, agents in economic models make decisions about whether to spend or to save their income. There are two types of savings in classical economic modeling. The first one is private saving. Your savings and my savings will fall into this category. Private saving is equal to household income after paying taxes to the government and after all consumption spending. The second type is public saving. This is saving by the government. Public saving is the difference between the incomes of the government and its expenditures. So, taxes minus government spending on education, healthcare, and other causes. The sum of private and public saving constitutes national saving. National saving is equal to national income, Y, after consumption, C, and government spending, G. Taxes, T, cancel out when we open the parenthesis. Now we can turn to investment. In the classical model, which is a simplified version of reality, all savings turn into an investment when they go through the financial system. For simplicity, let's assume that we are in a country with no export or import. Then, national income, Y, is a sum of consumption, C, government spending, G, and investment, I. The value of investment is exactly equal to the national saving. How one transition to the other has to do with the financial system. Assume that you deposited your savings into your bank account. Your savings have now entered the financial system. The financial system is the group of institutions that helps channel savings into efficient investments. The financial system includes financial markets, such as stock and bond markets. It also includes financial intermediaries, such as banks and mutual funds. In this way, the financial system helps to allocate scarce resources in the economy at any given time in the most efficient way. But let us for a moment return to that bank deposit that you made earlier. You and other households that had some income remaining after taxes and consumption bring your savings to the market. You form the supply of loanable funds. You earn interest on your savings, and the higher is the interest, the more you are willing to save. So, supply is, as usual, upward sloping. The supply of loanable funds is affected by many factors. The most important are the propensity to save of households and states. Demography also plays a role, as older people usually have more savings than younger people. Monetary policy, by expanding the money supply, can increase the amount of loanable funds. Tax policy can shift the propensity to save, for instance, by providing incentives to save or invest. There would be other agents in the economy that want to spend more than they earn. For example, there is a coffee shop down the road which decided to expand, and they need to borrow some money to invest in new coffee machines. They are the borrowers, the demand for funds. The demand of loanable funds is affected by many factors. The most important, or first, the general economic outlook. Firms see more future benefits and want to borrow more. Monetary policy also plays a role. Higher interest rates mean borrowing is more expensive. So, agents borrow less. Fiscal policy is a third factor. For instance, investment tax credit means funds will be cheaper for borrowers. Finally, the state can borrow. More state borrowing will increase the demand for loanable funds. As is usually the case, demand declines with the price of money, which is the interest rate. As in any other market, the interest rate, or zero, and the quantity of loanable funds, Q0, that are exchanged, are decided when supply is equal to demand. Now, imagine that the government decided to increase taxes on income, including the interest rate. This reduces incentives to save. As a result, supply decreases. It moves to the left, to supply 1 on your screen. The equilibrium rate moves from R0 to R1, and the equilibrium quantity moves from Q0 to Q1. Now, there is less supply, and as a result, less funds will be loaned and at a higher rate. Watch out about a common mistake. Investment is buying stock. Yes, but not only. In fact, if I put my money into a bank account, the bank will then lend this money to a firm, which will then use it, for instance, to buy productive equipment, which is a real investment. Time for a quick exercise. The economy is doing well and firms are very optimistic. They believe that the profits of their future investment projects will increase. How will that affect the market of loanable funds? Use the graph below to describe what happens to the equilibrium rate and equilibrium quantity in the market of loanable funds when firms become more optimistic about their future investments. Firms are now more optimistic about their investment project, so they would want to make more investments, and as a result, they need more borrowing. The demand for funds increases, so the demand curve moves outwards to demand 1. Now, there will be more funds loaned at a higher rate. R1 and Q1 are the new equilibrium rate and equilibrium quantity of the market. A quick recap. All after-tax income that is not spent on consumption becomes private saving. Government saving is equal to the difference between tax income and government spending. The financial system channels private and public savings into efficient investments. The amount of the funds borrowed on the market and their rate are decided by equating supply and demand. Public policies, such as changes in taxation and expectations about the future state of the economy, can change the equilibrium. Today, we discussed how the financial system turns savings into investments and how the market of loanable funds operates. Thanks for watching. Check out Chegg for more resources on macroeconomics.